Welcome back. Previously, we defined limit traits and an alarm state enumeration set. And you might be saying to yourself, well, that's all fine and dandy, but how are we going to use this with notifications? Well, now we're going to create the event frame templates used by notifications 2016 or later. And again, we're trying for a robust example, so I'm going to create the event frame templates in much the same manner that I would do for a real application. But let's keep in mind that this course is about developing applications. While configuration is certainly a part of that, we offer other courses specifically on how to configure those things. So I'm not really going to have you watch me type and walk through each and every configuration, but rather I've already done so, but we're going to go over it carefully of what I have already done. So let's jump over to event frame templates. You'll see I already have three in here, and there's a base general template and two specific ones for high and low. Now, I know that these use inheritance, but it's really tough to see that visually right now. So let's change the tree view by we're going to click on the event frame templates tree node, right click, we're going to go to arrange by and arrange by template inheritance. And lo and behold, you now see that the high and low clearly are underneath the general. So let's cover what's in the general alert first. Well, first let's go back and actually look at it. So we have the name, it's a tank general alert. The only other critical thing I want to have here is some naming pattern that's going to have the element template, the start time. For grins, I've put in can be acknowledged. Generally, I like to allow extensions on element templates, but not necessarily for event frame templates. So let's take a look at our attribute templates. For the ones called alert and condition, as you see, these are configuration items. Those are actually going to be mapped later by the analysis service, and I'll show you how that's done. The big one we have here is going to be starting level, which is a PyPoint data reference. One thing to keep in mind when values are going to be fetched off of an event frame is really what's the time context. So most data references default to where when a time range is put in and an event frame has a time range, that it's the end time of the time range where a value is returned. But in our case, we're concerned about, we want to know what was the level at the start time. Therefore, for our PyPoint configuration, we have to be sure to specify start time. Are in the dialog box, you will see it as such. The other important thing here is I've changed the name to starting level rather than just generic level, but keep in mind it's reading it from a parent element, and that parent element's name is actually level, as you see in here. So no longer can I use the percent attribute percent to grab that. Instead, I actually have to explicitly say I want the level. For any of you elderly people like myself who maybe have poor eyes, let's take a look at what that would look like blown up better. So as you can see, to reference your parent, the primary referenced element, we use the notation of dot slash elements, bracket, dot, bracket. And then in our case for level, we're going to do bar level. And you'll see that frequently. That's the big trick with event frames to primary referenced elements. Well, now, remember back on our element template, we went ahead and added limit traits. So those are brought down as well. As you see, I still have the same names. In this case, we are going to have to use the same pattern of level, but for the very ending piece, we are allowed to use percent attribute percent because we're grabbing the high from level, the high from level, etc. Now I'm using these as through String Builder, and you can do that. It's very nice and easy. And one cool thing about String Builder is while it returns a string, you can actually convert it to be something like a single or whatever matches your data. And again, if these limits happen to be PyPoints that we talked about earlier, then of course instead of String Builder, you definitely would want to use your PyPoint data reference here. And most likely you would also use the start time for a time range method. Other data we have in here, of course, is an average level. In that case, I'm still grabbing the level from my primary element, and I want to do an average. Maybe it's not necessary. I'm just trying to show some examples of what's possible. I'm not saying this is necessarily a good fit for you, but just to pique your curiosity about other things. I'm going to include the tank name down here, which is again through String Builder. And in this case, it is an element. It is a string, and it's just percent element percent. We're going to have this starting state be a formula, and we're going to map it back to an alarm state. But again, we have to use the hard-coded numbers that we've done in the alarm state before. And if we pop open this configuration box, you'll see the starting level is going to be parameter A, and then I've got the low, high, low, low, high, high, and then a big long equation. Let me kind of make that equation easier for you to read. So as you can see, I've mapped it again, and I put some colors in here to show you. And off to the right-hand side, I have that alarm state enumeration set to show us their low, high, etc. The equations I've kind of reorganized, maintaining those same colors, and I'm kind of showing you where it's going to be mapped into. So 4 is going to be a critical high. 3 is going to be mapped to critical low. So this little equation is going to return an integer. And the cool thing then about that integer is we have it mapped to alarm state, which will then map it to a friendly word such as high or critical high. Likewise, we have another attribute called worst state, which is right now an exact duplicate of starting state. It uses the starting level. But we're going to override that in one of our next templates. So let's take a look at one of them. Let's start with high. The important thing about high is that it does have the base template we're inheriting from Tank General Alert. I also have a nice naming pattern in there, same as before. And if your screen doesn't look like this, again, it's how you choose to group things. And in this case, I'm going to say show it by template inheritance. And so what happens is General Alert shows up, and you clearly see I've overridden the worst state. Well, the worst state is going to be based on the highest level. And highest level is going to be unique. Now, these are the same equations as before. So the worst state is going to be based on the highest level, and the highest level will just be similar to before, except we're choosing the maximum. And likewise, if we go over to Tank Low Level Alert, it's kind of a mirror image, but for the low thing, the worst state will be based on lowest level, and the lowest level is also now going to be a minimum. And with that, we now have our event frame templates all lined up and ready. The kicker is going to be we never will create an event frame directly from Tank General Alert. We're always going to create one now specifically to either a high-level alert or a low-level alert, and we'll cover that in the very next section.